Gabriel and the Cheeky Monkeys by James Parsons. The mobile phone.
My own mobile phone? Cool! I can't wait to show Evan at kindergarten, beamed Gabriel as he took charge of his present.
Come here and I'll show you how it works, beamed Daddy back. He was relieved that his choice of present met with approval.
Can I call anyone in the whole wide world on this phone? Asked Gabriel, looking at the display and wondering where the buttons were.
Of course, said Daddy, but you need to know the number and remember, each call costs money.
Silence.
Gabriel thought for a bit.
He knew lots of people, but didn't know any of their telephone numbers. He was only 5 and was still learning to read and write. And he didn't have any pocket money, but he did have a few coins, including a 10-cent coin, which he'd found in the playground of the kindergarten. His teacher told him he could keep it.
What's your number, Daddy? Asked Gabriel.
Daddy helped his son to type in the numbers one by one and push the save button. Gabriel practiced finding the number on the phone and even called it just to make sure it worked. Owning a mobile phone made Gabriel feel very grown up indeed. The mobile phone followed Gabriel everywhere. He showed it to all the guests who arrived for the morning celebrations. Gabriel always celebrated his birthday in the morning with his family. In the evening, the grown-ups had their own parties. After all, it was New Year's Eve. Sometimes Gabriel felt sad that he had to wait longer to celebrate his birthday than all the other children, because his birthday was on the last day of the year. For the afternoon, Gabriel had invited his 2 best friends, Evan and Isabel, to the zoo. Because it was icy cold outside, Gabriel was looking forward to Gondwanaland, as it was always as warm as summer inside. Daddy had brought an extra big rucksack for the winter clothes of the 3 friends. Soon they were inside and peeling off their thick jumpers and scarves and running around. No prizes for guessing where they headed first. The Cheeky Monkeys. There were hardly any visitors on the bridge, and the zookeeper looked quite relaxed for once.
Hello, my friend, said the zookeeper. What a surprise to see you today.
It's my birthday, said Gabriel shyly, and Daddy gave me a mobile phone as a present.
Gabriel proudly held out the shiny phone and,
oh no, stop!
One of the monkeys was quicker than the fastest Easter bunny and had swooped from the tree and grabbed the phone out of Gabriel's hand. In the blink of an eye, he was gone.
Oh, I am sorry, said the zookeeper. We have signs up all over the place now warning people about the cheeky monkeys. They seem to like cameras and mobiles.
This didn't really comfort Gabriel at all. He couldn't really be angry with his monkey friends, but he did want his phone back.
How do we get it back? Asked Daddy. I have an idea, said the zookeeper. Give me a minute.
It seemed like ages before the zookeeper returned. His face told the bad news. No mobile. Daddy tried to comfort Gabriel, but the day was ruined. The whole birthday was ruined. Even looking at the other animals couldn't cheer him up. Daddy said he wasn't angry and that Gabriel was just unlucky. They decided to return home early. Daddy gave the zookeeper his business card in case the mobile turned up. Then, just as they got to the car, Daddy's telephone rang. You would not believe who was on the line. Was it the cheeky monkey who'd pushed the redial button? Daddy listened, and then after a few seconds he said thank you and hung up.
That was the monkey who took your phone, Gabriel. He wanted to call his cousins in South America, but he'd forgotten the dialing code for Brazil. He said we can go back and pick up the phone now. Come on, let's all have a race back to Gondwanaland.
Joy returned instantaneously to Gabriel's face. He was so happy. A few minutes later, the zookeeper came around the corner.
Here you are, little man.
Thank you, and please say thank you to the cheeky monkeys. I'll find out the dialing code for Brazil and bring it next time, said Gabriel.
The zookeeper looked a bit puzzled, but didn't say anything. Daddy smiled.
Happy New Year, Mr. Zookeeper, said Gabriel.
Thank you, little man. Enjoy the rest of your birthday, smiled the zookeeper.